Hello, I'm back. I'm on a different computer. Did anyone hang with me? I wouldn't blame you if you didn't. I wouldn't have. I'd be out doing something. By the way, I just set the chat to go live. I didn't do the only members can do questions. So, sorry about that. If you're a member, I will look at your question first, of course. You will get preferential treatment. But anyway, hello to everybody. The first and most important question is there buffering? Is there still buffering? Is there no buffering? What say you? Hey, everybody. If you're not a member, please join. Now that we have the entire internet joining in on this chat. Oh, great tomato girl. Oh, my God. I see a familiar face. Hello there. No buffering. Yeah, well, that's how the other one started. And then you guys jinxed me, and there was buffering. Anyway, welcome again. Welcome again. Thank you to all the members that stuck with me. We tried to do the chat earlier, and there was buffering, even though I did a speed test and have new gigaspeed internet access. And I was promised there would be zero buffering. In fact, they pretty much said if there's buffering, something just is seriously wrong with you. You're doing something wrong because it's not the equipment. But anyway, I'm going to scroll up. If you want to be a member, just hit the join button. It's under every and any video. And above and beyond getting access to the chat questioning abilities, you also get updates from Kismet. This is Kismet. Let me show you a picture out the window. Michelle and I moved, or are in the process of moving into a new studio. Very exciting. There's going to be a reveal at some point. But anyway, that's the background. And all the members that have joined so far have been helping support that effort for me and Michelle to start our little two and a quarter acre farm workshop, culinary school, internet video recipe studio, and new home of the Food Wish Empire. So anyway, that's just what we're doing here, why this looks different if you've been in on an older chat. All right, so first things first. Oh, and by the way, the new computer I'm on has all different size. Are they called ports? The holes in the side of the computer is what I call them. And grandparents everywhere, we call them the little holes in the side. So I can't plug a microphone in. So you're stuck with the laptop microphone. Sorry about that. I also can't plug in. Well, that's pretty much it. Oh, I can't plug in the Ethernet either because it doesn't have the right size hole. I mean, the thing is one size and the hole's a different size. What are you going to do? You just can't shove it in. They say never force it. So I'm going to work on that. But in the meantime, it looks like there's no buffering. I spelled live wrong. Oh, no, I didn't. Did I?
Yes.
Oh, my God. What a mess. Listen, people, I'm paid to cook. Not to, and amuse Michelle. Not to do anything else. So everything else is gravy. Okay, let me catch up on some questions from the members. And I might take a couple of non-member questions. Since I'm in a good mood, the internet might be working now. So are we sure there's no buffering? Because I can still maybe get in, mix in a little bit of buffering if you guys are missing it. All right, here we go. All right, here we go.
You look good.
Okay. Keep it down in there. All right, no buffering yet. Garden Girl is a little skeptical. I don't blame her. My voice instills tremendous confidence in Spiro. Thank you very much. Old Man Musclewhite, how you doing, Jamie? It seems much better. What do you mean much better? Is there still a little buffering, but it's better? Or is it like perfect now? Grape Tomato Girl, the chat is on regular. Everybody, it's a free-for-all. But I think I can pick out the member question, so don't worry about it. But it's nice everybody's getting to put in their two cents. I definitely get way more compliments this way, so that works out. People are liking hearing Michelle in the background. What country's food do you like the most? USA, USA. And I'll tell you why. Because we steal everybody's best recipes. We appropriate them like there's nobody, like no one can do anything about it, which they can't. So I would say America has the best food. But as you know, I do two recipes a week from every single country. I think I've done literally a recipe from every cuisine in the world. So I don't discriminate. I like all food from everywhere. I could not pick. I could not pick one country. Thanks, Sober Now. Better than Jack Scalfani? Never heard of him. Is that a YouTuber? Jamie, thanks, Michelle, for the woohoo. Grape Tomato Girl. Yeah, you're probably seeing it scroll by faster than I am because I'm actually able to go through fairly carefully. Hello, Stephanie. Or hello, Stefan, sorry. From the Netherlands. Have I done a Netherlandish recipe? I'm not sure.
Jackie wants to know about the cottage cheese.
Okay. Keep it down in there. I haven't seen any actual food questions, but we'll get to them. Oh, Jackie, how have I ever made cottage cheese loaf? Is that a bread? I don't think I've ever made cottage cheese loaf, but I love cottage cheese. In fact, a little story, when I used to work down at Fisherman's Wharf, I worked in a cookie store and had no money. So the only thing I could afford for like my one meal of the day, basically, there was a salad bar, an all-you-can-eat salad bar at a restaurant that was like a couple blocks from the cookie store. And I think it was, I don't know, maybe $6, I'm going to say $5, $6 for all-you-can-eat salad bar. And it was a terrible salad bar, just lettuce and some chickpeas and some horrible cherry tomatoes. But for whatever reason, they had a giant vat of cottage cheese, really good cottage cheese. And I used to just live on that. I would eat 3 to 4 pounds of cottage cheese a day. And that's not even that much of an exaggeration. So cottage cheese actually sustained me for a good portion of my, I think, 22nd year of life. I'm guessing at that time frame. Thank you, everybody. Good to hear you too. See you too. The most tender pan-fried steak is beef tenderloin, but don't use it. Use something else. Because you can take a tougher cut of meat, pound it out, and it makes even a better pan-fried steak if you're going to bread it and do like a chicken fried steak thing. Steak Diane, good to see you back. I'm scrolling through looking for member questions because I discriminate against non-members when it comes to questions, right? If you want to ask a question, it's going to cost you like $1 a week, but totally worth it, especially now that we've eliminated the buffering, which Michelle maybe is laughing because she's skeptical that we've actually done that. At some point, I'll figure out how to go back to the old system. Prathmesh, is culinary school worth it? Yes, if you have unlimited funds, it's a fun year or two to take off, go to culinary school. If you don't have like millions of dollars to blow, don't go to culinary school. Just go work for some chefs. Prep cook, dishwash, work your way up, learn the business, decide if you like it, and then you can go from there. In fact, you could do that first and then go to culinary school. Most people try to do it the other way around. Go to culinary school, pay all the money, get out, graduate, and then go work in restaurants. And they realize, oh my God, this is the hardest job ever. And I'm making no money. Why did I do that? Now I wish I had my $40,000 back from school. So I would say go work in restaurants before you even think of going to a for money culinary school. Or just try to take some free classes on YouTube from people like me. And we got your back. Thanks, Mark. You're looking great too. Nathan Shorts, you're welcome. I hope I've helped the family during these crazy times. That makes me feel good. Enrico has a demi-glaze question. Can I make demi-glaze with lamb bones, T-bones, rib bones? That's all I have. Well, you can make a nice broth slash stock with those kind of bones and scraps. But to get a real demi-glaze that has all that gelatin, all that sticky goodness that when you reduce it down, you get what we consider a classic demi-glaze, you really need those sort of knuckle joints that have all the collagen and the elastin that will actually, you know, dissolve as it simmers. That's what gives you that richness. So you can make a stock with like rib bones and such, but it doesn't have, as much of that connective tissue and gelatin. The collagen turns into gelatin, by the way, not to get technical. But anyway, no, you can't make a classic demi-glaze simply with those kind of bones. Whoops, what happened? Oh, there we go. Something popped up on my screen. I was getting too cocky. The technology was working. And the computer was like, how you like me now? And a thing popped up. I had to click exit. Claudette, non-member question. I'll take a few. Her creme fraiche is soft. Why? Creme fraiche is supposed to be soft. If you mean it's too soft, like liquidy, then you need to let it ferment longer. So try it again. Leave it out on the counter an extra day, maybe. You're not gonna poison yourself. Don't worry. And if you do, we're not legally liable. The legal department wants me to tell you that. But you just need to leave it out at room temp a little longer, so it has more of a culture, active culture growing and fermenting that cream, and then you can refrigerate. Try that instead. Serpin, no, I'm not wearing mom jeans now. I'm wearing black shorts. That may be similar to what a boxer might wear. I forget the actual name of the piece of clothing, but it's, you know, it's the shorts the boxers wear. Is the typo in the title on purpose? It is not. Nothing I do ever, including most of the videos I post, is on purpose. So there you go. David Carbone, congrats on solving the buffering. Kismet Homestead is looking great. Vultures are discriminating. Yes, they are. There's nothing pickier than a vulture. See what I did there? Pick. All right. Whoops. A bunch of questions flew by. And thank you, member patients. Thank you, members, for their patience. Would all be another way to say that in English. This is a one-off where we're just, it's a free-for-all because I was all flustered and I needed to figure out what the problem was. Apparently, it's my 14-year-old laptop. Who would have thought that you can't use a laptop for two decades and have it work perfectly? So maybe that was the problem. And now I'm thinking I upgraded to this super expensive internet system for nothing. So there you go. Foiled again.
Join, members, join.
What's that?
Members need to join.
Okay, enough from the peanut gallery. So you can tell I'm like in my late 50s because who uses peanut gallery? You guys will have to Google that. That was from, I don't know, the Mickey Mouse Club, I think, which you, again, you have no idea what that is. Bill Schaefer, my old buddy Bill. At some time, could I suggest a basic set of cookware? I cannot and will not. And here's why. I'd say get the biggest set you can afford. You're not going to get pieces you don't need. You never have enough pots and pans. Excuse me. And my system for which brand, I think all the top brands, and you know the ones I'm talking about, like if you do a Google search, like best cookware sets, all those top, like say five brands, they're all really good. All right. You're all Clad, you're Staub, your Cuisinart, your KitchenAid, I have a set of Better Homes and Gardens, which is like a lower end set. Fantastic. So I say search for one of the nice sets, compare prices, and get the highest rated cookware set in your price range. That's always the best, you know, system for me. So, you know, it's not any more complicated than that. It depends on what you can afford. You know, but as far as the number of things, you have to have, of course, your stock pots and your saucepan and your frying pan. So as many pieces as you can get, I say go for it. And then you can fill in with an extra different larger and or smaller saute pan, one for eggs, one for giant things, your cast iron skillets, of course. And then you fill in with those kind of pieces. But any of your basic cookware sets are going to do the job. I like just a stainless steel set. That's just me. If you can swing it, a stainless steel set and a nonstick set, very good. They all have their own uses. So, Bill, that's about as specific as I would get. What everyday use, I mean, whatever you see me using in the videos, those most popular four or five pans and pots, that's what I would get. You see the same pot show up in almost every video. So that's kind of how you can tell, you know, the 5-quart stock pot and the 3-quart saucepan and so forth. So maybe one of these days, when and if I ever get it like an intern, which I've never had, we'll put together a list of cookware that I use like specifically, and maybe you could base it on that. Hello from East Tennessee. Hello, East Tennessee. I didn't know you guys had internet. That's cool. Sorry, I got to do a Tennessee joke. They got a good sense of humor down there. I've been through very briefly. Oh, that's right. Michelle's telling me our tile is from Tennessee. Thank you. I'm this person's favorite YouTube channel. That's very good to hear. Abner. Yes, Michelle is having a good day. Very active today, yes. Buddy Christ, how you doing, buddy? I like your avatar. You look exactly like, I can't place it. Looks very familiar. The beard, I don't know. Maybe a bartender in Brooklyn, I'm not sure. Oh, buddy paid $5 to make this bad rhyme, so I'll share it. Love hearing Michelle in the background. By the way, it's Michelle with one L.
Yeah.
Never make that mistake again. Because after all, she is the wife of our favorite guy who uses a chef knife. Wife of a chef. All right. And then they put the backslash rim shot for a sound effect. Very good. All right. Ripe watermelon. Make a proposition for 2021. Make a food wish meal from a different country each week. That's not a dumb idea. I might just do that. Thanks, James. Kavanaugh joined. I would like to see a lot more of you members or subscribers joining to become members. And trust me, Michelle would like that too. Rob Kennedy, have I ever considered stand-up or comedy writing? Yeah, I do it on the channel. You think those jokes and one-liners in the videos just write themselves? That's what I spend most of my waking hours doing, writing dumb jokes. Thank you for people commenting on the mustache. That's never not disturbing. Pretty soon I'm going to have to color it all dark and look like one of those freaks. In fact, if you ever watch local television, the sports guy, who's usually like 50 to 60, always has like a black mustache, but then gray hair other spots. It's weird. Or I have to let it all get white, and then I'll look like one of those guys with a white mustache. So I'm not sure which way I'm going to go. All right, scrolling down, making sure I didn't miss any member questions. Because, you know, members get priority. They pay the good money. It's like $1.25 a week. You got to give them something back. Sharon says, Peanut Gallery was Howdy Doody. Interesting. That's right, I think. I barely remember Howdy Doody. See, I'm not that old. All right, you can't read from the other room because I can't see it here, honey. Michelle's trying to help, but she's confusing me, which I'm so easily confused. You wouldn't believe it. Angie Holiday, a member question. How can I get most of the day rendered from my whole roasted duck? Most of the day rendered. I'm confused by that. I don't have any special equipment. Spatchcock, score the breast. Most of the fat? Is that what you're trying to say? I blame the microphone when people use like the mics to type in the stuff. Voice control, is that what it's called? Yeah, you definitely want to score the skin, not down to the flesh, just through the fat, and go back and forth. In fact, if you watch any of our duck breast videos, we show you how to do that. That is the best way to get stuff rendered out of a whole duck. If that was your question, by the way. No, people asking if Michelle's the lady in my iconic profile picture. No, that was a complete stranger that for some reason was draped over my shoulder with a feather boa at an after party at the Aspen Food and Wine Festival many years ago, at an after party thrown by Patron Tequila, I believe. And that was in a photo booth at probably 2 to 3 in the morning. And I have no idea why I picked that as my avatar picture way back when. I thought it made me look cool, like a jet-setting food blogger, food writer guy. But really, it just made me look like a drunk idiot in a photo booth. But anyway, I was afraid, branding-wise, that if I changed that, people wouldn't know it was Food Wishes. So, you know, I kept it. And I should probably get a new one. It's probably inappropriate. See, we change, we grow, we evolve. And long story short, we can't get away with things we used to get away with for the better. Thank God. Enrico, Demiglaze, can I get the collagen by using chicken feet? Yes. Chicken feet have tons of collagen. So, yes, any feet of any animal, shank, ankle bones, that's where you get lots of the collagen. And any joint that looks like a ball joint, which is if you buy veal bones for stock, if you tell the butcher, I want to make demi-glaze, I need the joints, they will actually cut those pieces for you. Excuse me. Rick wants to know, cooking in or out, what's the best way to support farmers? Both. They grow the food that either goes to the store or the restaurant. So do both, and you'll always help farmers. All you have to do to help farmers is eat and not grow your own food, basically. But you should do that too. You're welcome, Bill. Thanks, Tom. Happy holidays to you. Thank you, everybody. Have I tried Peruvian ceviche? Gene wants to know. Have I tried it? There's been times where I've lived on it. Ceviche is one of my favorite things in the world, especially Peruvian ceviche with the ají amarillo, chili peppers, and oh my God. If I could just eat one cold appetizer the rest of my life, I might just pick a ceviche. So I know it's a bold statement. The Harry Channel, I'm super motivated to try your sinfone recipe. Sinfone, I forget how you say it. Sinfone. My mother's maiden name was Sinfone, so that pizza reminds me of their name. So I always end up saying it like Sinfone. But anyway, it's a Sicilian, Southern Italian pizza that has tons of anchovies and I believe onions and breadcrumbs. And it is like crazy, insanely delicious and so different than your average pizza. Try that recipe. The Harry Channel. Look at the chat. Copy paste it. It's really hard to say, but absolutely delicious. Grape Tomato Girl. The birds posted were auditioning. Yes. Thank you. I hope they were auditioning for my next recipe and not casting a spell. It looks so weird. So anyway, if you remember, I post pictures from Kismet. I try to do it as often as I can, and there's going to be a lot more coming. But there was these two vultures, turkey vultures, which are huge vultures. And they sit in this big pine tree behind the house. And usually they just sit there, but this time they had their wings open like this. It was so ominous. And they just held it like that. And they would kind of look down at me once in a while. And it looked like they were cursing me and putting a spell on the entire property. But I've been told that's not what they were doing. They're sunning their wings and trying to kill lice was the official answer. I'm still a little nervous, but I feel better. So thanks, Grape Tomato. No, and I'm not going to cook them. I have no turkey vulture recipes. Circle square, shortening or butter for donuts? You know, I'm a butter guy. I don't like shortening. Our parents used a lot of shortening, and look how we turned out. So I'm not blaming them. That's what they had. But I think less shortening, probably not a bad idea. And no, pink burgers do not cause disease and salmonella. They can, I guess, technically. But no. And if you're scared of that, buy your own meat, sear the outside, then grind it, and then you can cook your burger as rare as you want, and you don't have to worry about that there was anything on the surface that then got into your burger that then you know, turned into a problem with foodborne illness. Welcome, James. So we're getting a few new members. That's good to see. Laura Hayes, I know what you mean. I have never had fried cornbread. Yeah, cornbread, I don't know if you need to fry. In fact, regular cornbread made in a cast iron skillet, there's so much fat in the pan and in the recipe, it kind of fries when it bakes. So I think that counts. No, I will never get tired of cooking. Yes, being a YouTube icon is worth it. Is that what I am? You've been watching since 2015? That's a long time ago. Although I've been doing it since 2007, so you've got some catching up to do. No, I've never thought of a slow cooker series because I'm not a big fan of the slow cooker. I don't have a good reason why. I think I've talked about this before. Same with pressure cookers. If you're into them, I got nothing but respect and love for you. But I'm a creature of habit. I like to, you know, sear and then put the liquid in and let it braise and simmer slowly. And I'll check it every couple hours. And that's part of the process, part of the ritual of cooking for me. Excuse me. Thanks, DM Clay. DM Clay joined. If DM Clay could join, so can you. Niwa Garden Girl, any suggestions on what to do with beets? Yes, roast them with walnuts, walnut oil, some black pepper, lots of salt. Roast them until they're beautiful. In fact, you got to cook them first. I should have mentioned that. So boil your beets or roast them in the skins, then quarter them, cut them in pieces, then coat them with a little bit of walnut oil, some walnuts, roast those until they get a little bit roasty on the outside, and then serve that with some goat cheese. That's one of my favorite salads of all time involving beets. I'm not a huge beets guy, but with walnuts and goat cheese, man, I love that. So roasted beets with goat cheese and walnut is my official answer to what garden girls should do with beets. Yes, I know Grape Tomato Girl. There would be no shortage of applicants. I just don't know how much it costs to do all the background checks. And then they have to sign, you know, waivers. I have to, you know, swear them to secrecy because they'll give away all my, you know, trade secrets and stuff. So it might be more complicated than I think. Why are people asking me about my jeans? They're not high and tight. They are low and loose. That's how all those players wear them. I'll find them. Every steak I make is tough. Maybe try a different recipe. All right, scrolling down, looking for members. Well, looking for members to join, but also looking for member questions. By the way, we also post extra videos about what goes on here at Kismet. Rarely, but we do. There'll be more of those once we're set up and the house doesn't look like this. See, it's all completely trashed, and we're still setting up. There's a giant electrical panel on the wall that we have to cover. I'm going to do one of those really cool moss art pieces. Michelle and I are going to make a big frame, like, I don't know, 6 feet by 4 feet, and then we're going to pick and slice and dice a million different little sticks with moss and lichen which is sort of a moss-like, scaly, beautiful, light green thing that grows on wood. And we're going to make our own art piece. And we're not even going to care if it's good or not. Because when people come over, we'll be like, we made that. And they will nod politely. And they will say, that's really cool, even if they don't think so. So that's the plan. Thank you, person. I can't pronounce your name, for the dollar. Appreciate it. P. Mumbrion. That's was probably really close. And by the way, I have to compliment you all. There is a shockingly low number of insane comments and inappropriate comments. So I've always said Food Wishes has like the best audience on YouTube, and that's not just blowing smoke. If you look at other food channels, the comments, it is it's a nightmare. I don't know how they do it. We actually get smart, intelligent, funny people on a regular basis leaving comments. With me, to me, for me, and with each other. And it is very, very heartwarming. Lincoln, if you want a shout out for your cat, Louie, it's going to cost way more than $5, dude. So Louie the cat, sorry, no shout out today. Go back to whatever you were doing, probably just doing nothing, since that's what cats do. And by the way, if you remember, thanks, Rafael. If I missed your member question, just post it again. This was a free-for-all. I started a chat earlier, didn't work. Total technical glitches. We figured out it's my laptop, not the connection. So that was the major breakthrough today. Jocelyn Daniels, I know you made a prime rib recipe a long time ago, but could you explain the benefit of doing the reverse sear method as well as the benefit of dry aging? Well, dry aging benefit is as you leave it in your fridge drying out, literally, you're losing water, which is concentrating and making the meat a little bit denser, just slightly, but it is concentrating the flavor and tightening up the texture a bit. So that's why we dry brine and dry age. It gives it the seasoning, salt, whatever time to work its way into the meat. And it the 10-pound prime rib will actually end up at like 8 pounds if you leave it in there long enough by the time you roast it. According to my good friend who I've never met, who possibly just went insane, Alton Brown. So anyway, that's why you dry age. Reverse sear, you know, I don't do a lot of reverse searing. That's like roast first or cook the meat first and then get it crust in the pan. I'm a sear first and then finish the cooking guy. So that's my answer to that. Excuse me. And there are way too many comments to read and catch up with here. So that you're answering each other's questions, I really appreciate it. Burning Diamond wants to know, can I please do a collab with Kenji Lopez? Yes, I can. I know he refers to me a lot in my videos. He lives in the Bay Area. I'm a huge fan. I cannot believe we've never had beers together, which we have to do. So yes, every time I do a chat, someone should suggest that. And I need to do that. I assume you guys are telling him the same. So one of these days we'll get it together. Probably after the COVID thing. It's hard to get together, all right? Everyone's got to be smart. We can't just all get together because we want to, all right? This is not a fake deal. Come on. But no, after all the limitations and we don't have to stick to our pods, all right? Do you ever think you'd be in a pod? But anyway, after the pod phase of life, we go back to normal. I'm going to look up Kenji and we're gonna talk shop. We're going to talk shop for a long time. So Bernie Diamond, thank you for the suggestion. That is on the list. James Kavanaugh, valued member, wants to know if I made TIA. Is that how you say it? TIA. You can tell that I don't know how to say it. I haven't made it. So Michelle will now Google TIA and tell me what that is. I have no clue. excuse me, EA, member EA wants to know, am I going to eat the moss and lichen? No, I hadn't thought of that. Can I? Is moss and lichen edible? Thank you for people that like the painting. It's actually a print that I did illegally off the internet because I could not find the source or the artist that would provide prints for money. Thanks, Yolanda, for joining. Welcome aboard. There's very little chance you're going to regret this move. Thank you. My favorite holiday candy is, what's a holiday candy? Is that a thing? I don't know if there's holiday candy. I'll go candy cane. It's the only thing I can think of. I'm not sure about holiday candy. I know about holiday cookies. I've been brainstorming some of those because I'm going to film one tomorrow, I believe. I don't want to tell you what it is, though, yet. It's going to be a huge surprise. All right, I'm doing my best to find the member questions. Evan King, pan sauce for a bacon wrap filet. Pan sauce for a bacon wrap filet. I'm assuming you mean beef filet wrapped with bacon. Well, since the bacon has like sweetness to it, I would go for something a little bit on the sharper end, like a vinegar-based pan sauce. Even a red wine, I think, would be nice. Something that has a little bit of acidity to it. Something sharp. So like a black pepper, a splash of red wine, lots of black pepper, maybe a splash of tarragon vinegar, I think would be lovely, or some white wine vinegar with some fresh tarragon, and finish with butter, of course, as we do all the classic pan sauces. Evan, that's going to be your pan sauce for a bacon wrap filet, I think. But pretty much any of the pan sauces we've ever done for beef on the channel would work. Ash Dien made the winter ribs instead of turkey, plus quick blackened grill. Sounds good. Ribs instead of turkey? I'd eat that. Jeff Seifert, my sense of humor is a delight. Enjoy the commentary. Thank you so much. I'm glad you have laughs at my expense, or laughing with me and at me is fine. I really do this to amuse myself, a lot of it, with the dumb jokes, so that other people get a chuckle once in a while is really nice to hear. By the way, is the microphone on this laptop horrible? Because maybe I don't need to buy an adapter for my microphone. I'd like to wear one of the ear things, though, like the with this thing that goes here. I always think that makes people look really smart online. Joel Finkel, do restaurants pre-cook proteins? Oh, you better believe they do. Joel, this is another thing my friends in the restaurants do not want me to tell you. But yes, almost always in a busy restaurant, they will pre-cook some of the proteins. They will pre-sear some of the steaks. They will pre-roast some of the chicken. They will grill some of the pork chops. And then when you order them, they finish them off. Having said that, it's not a big deal. As long as it comes out delicious and beautiful and moist and tasty, who cares what they did? So it doesn't make it a bad restaurant that they pre-cook things. In fact, if you can successfully pre-cook part of my dinner and I can be served in 15 minutes instead of 45 minutes, I'm totally good with that. So yes, I don't have a problem with that strategy. Putting corn in cornbread, Nanette wants to know. Makes really good corn fritters. Oh, putting corn in cornbread batter makes really good corn fritters. She tops with butter and maple syrup, or syrup, as we say in Western New York. Nanette, I love that idea. I love you posted that. And now I want homemade fresh corn fritters. I'm going to have that for lunch, maybe. And I know there's not fresh corn season. I don't care. I'll have it flown up from South America or something. All right, I'm reading comments I don't understand, so people must be chatting while I'm scrolling through. EA wants to know, is pheasant worth trying to cook? No, it's not. Don't cook pheasant. You cook duck, something with a little more meat on it. And again, a terrible attitude. If you want to try pheasant, I say by all means, go for it. But for the same reason I don't cook a lot of quail recipes, it's a tasty little bird with little tiny breasts and little tiny legs. And the wings, you got to gnaw like this. I like a little more meat on the bones, so to speak. But it is a lovely flavor. A little bit on the gamey side, sort of like a duck, similar to a, I would say, like a duck leg flavor. So if someone serves me a pheasant, I'm eating it every time, all day. But as far as recommending people go out and find pheasant to buy and cook, put it on your bucket list. Everyone should have pheasant once in their life, I guess, which is weird advice. But, yeah, pheasant, if you can find it and it's not crazy expensive and you want to just try it, no harm, no foul. But not my favorite, you know, poultry to cook. I guess not technically poultry. My favorite flying animal to cook. I love duck so much that I get the same fix with way more meat for the money. So probably a bad answer, but that's just my honest feelings. Kevin Yavno, member, wants to know, what does the bay leaf do in recipes? It doesn't smell like anything. I know, it's weird, but it does something. So here's how you can tell what bay leaves do. You have to make two batches of a soup. Chicken noodle would be a perfect one to try with, or a beef, like a beef shank simmered. Do one saucepan with a couple bay leaves and one without the bay leaves. You have to make two different, the same soup, same recipe, divide it into two pots once it's all together, and then simmer one with the bay leaves, simmer one without the bay leaves. And then once they're done, you taste, compare, taste, contrast, make some notes, have a lively discussion with your guests, and then you'll know what bay leaves do. Okay, that's your homework. Oh yes, Hobby Night reminds me, don't forget to hit the like button. I never tell people to do that in videos. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification button. Which reminds me, while you're here, hit the like button and hit the subscribe button, hit the join button, hit the notification button. Because I know on your phones you don't get enough notifications. I think you need a couple more reasons for your phone to ring, like when I post anything. So I would love it if everyone would go turn on notifications today, because then you'll never miss anything. But I can't say that during a video. I just cannot bring myself to it. Jocelyn, one of our first members to sign up for rewards. I got a notification from your channel and immediately signed up. I've not regretted it for a single day. See, that's a Jocelyn Daniels testimonial. She's very, very particular, by the way. So what she says carries a lot of weight in this area. Thank you, Jocelyn. I appreciate that. What is my inspiration? Michelle, life, kismet. Hold on, one more look. I mean, come on. How do you don't get inspired living in that? Inspiration is all around us. I think I saw that on a greeting card one time that I didn't buy. But it was a nice thought. Lee Stube or Stubb. I heard Alton Brown is a jerk, which would not surprise me in the least. I can't comment. I've never met him. But he did go semi-insane during the last couple months, apparently, on YouTube, and or on Twitter, rather. But so have I. So I shouldn't comment. We're all a little nuts. Thank you, Michael. Thank you, old Greg. Everything's edible if you're brave enough. Old Greg. Sorry, old Greg. That's some great advice. And by the way, I have to give credit where credit's due. Whenever you hear me saying the old Tapa Tapa or the old Shaka Shaka or old man Muscle White, I'm stealing that from a not famous baseball player, but if you're a San Francisco Giants baseball fan, excuse me, losing my voice, he is famous, Mike Kruko. Mike Kruko was a pitcher for the Giants, who during the broadcast, whenever he would say the word old, talking about an old pitching coach or the old curveball or whatever, he would always say the old, and he would do the voice thing. So I basically stole that. And I don't know what it is. People love when you do, when you say things that are old and use the old man voice, like old man Mitsuwich. So anyway, that's why I do it. A little behind the scenes comments or info that you don't get in the normal production. Fourth girl. Okay, shit. Okay, chef. Did I just say shit accidentally? Okay, chef. We hit all the buttons. I don't know what that means. Fourth girl, explain yourself. Smash it like a clove of garlic, James says. Again, don't know what you're referring to. Oh, Joel, Big Night was an excellent assignment. I'm glad. I assigned people to watch The Big Night or Big Night. It's actually not called The Big Night. If you weren't around for that homework and you're looking for a movie to watch during the holidays, Big Night, best food movie ever. Check it out. Oh, I'm supposed to tell people to smash that like button, not hit it. The cool kids say smash now. Like they don't eat a steak, they smash the steak. The steak and the snake. Shit. Whoop, did it again. Girly Fish, thank you for joining. I was hoping to get 10,000 new members by the end of the chat, so we got to really pick up the pace here, people. Kelly did and Jules did, YT1. Did you make a Thanksgiving leftover sandwich? Well, thank you for asking. I most certainly did. The whole reason to cook Thanksgiving traditional stuff is to make the sandwich after. So, yes, I did. Very enjoyable. Excuse me. Yes. Ni Hu. I'm trying to pronounce these names. Please bear with me. Nahu Lagareta, new member, I believe. Started using bay leaves after culinary school, but dried's better than fresh. Yes, great point. Many of you might have a bay tree near your house and think, hey, fresh bay leaves, these have to be better. No, they're much worse. They're very resinous and it's almost inedible. Do not ever, under any circumstances, whether they're new or old bay leaves from a tree, do not use them. They have to be dried. They have to be from the Mediterranean, preferably Greece or Turkey. And that's the bay leaf you use in stews and soups and stuff. Don't go to your over the fence and pick your neighbor's bay tree thinking you're, you know, getting over on everybody. All right. You need to use dry bay leaves only. So thank you for that. All right. Let me scroll down here. I know I'm missing a ton of members' questions. I'm sorry. But the good news is we figured out the buffering. So next chat, we'll do in a couple weeks. We'll go back to the normal system. But I'm glad everyone's getting in on this now. Maybe I'll do just a chat for non-members that's not even included in the normal routine. So we'll see. Now that I have this technology, I'm just going to just take advantage of it. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you, Ashley. Please make more Indian recipes. I will try. Love Indian food. Mimi, Eminem, thank you very much. Good luck to your brother, JP, as he starts culinary school. Hopefully one day he opens a famous restaurant and I get to eat for free. That would be great. No, I don't have any moderators. I'll set some up next time. I haven't noticed any trolls. Don't care. Just ignore them. What are they doing? I don't see any trolling. I'll block their ass once I figure out how to do that. Michael says, people smoke bay leaves. I don't think so. And if you're thinking of it, don't. Pretty sure that's toxic. Michael loves our chocolate mousse recipe. Thank you very much. But I think you spelled mousse wrong. Chocolate mousse is a completely different recipe. That's like a mousse mole, which is very delicious, but different than the dessert. Ramen, yes, you can tell your husband he's wrong now about the bay leaves. Is there anything better than learning something that you can then tell your spouse they were wrong about? That's like the ultimate. Right, Michelle?
Right. I have no battery on my computer.
Yes, Bill, the world is my oyster dip. Oyster dip, is that a thing? I need some dip suggestions that we haven't filmed already for the upcoming January, February football playoffs, Super Bowl. Is it still going to be on schedule? I don't know. If you have a dip recipe we haven't done that you must see, please pass it along now. Does anyone know what time it is?
12:18.
Oh my God, I'm way over time, but we had problems at the beginning. So I'm just going to keep talking until I give out. If you members need to go, I know you were here early, started at 11 a.m. I appreciate the effort. My apologies for having to change and do the impromptu chat, but that's life.
22.
Ryan, Linville, new member, or actually old member. My fiance says celery is pointless. How can I convince her otherwise? Ryan, I don't know how to say this. You're going to need a new fiance. There's no convincing people to think celery is pointless, that it has a point. I'm sure you guys are close. I know this is probably going to be difficult, but the sooner you cut her loose, the better, I think, just for your well-being. You can't go through your whole life feeling bad about adding celery to things and having to argue about celery. Imagine 30, 40 years of celery arguments. No. So please, Ryan's fiance, if you're listening, celery does have a point. Bitter ingredients in recipes make the other ingredients taste sweeter, better, more savory. So celery might seem completely pointless to a non-celery lover, but all the recipes that you have celery in, like a beef stew or a soup or a sauce, if you take it out, you'll notice a difference. So celery has a point. So few things do. Celery is one of them. Yes, I am a fan of chicken paprikash. And I will make that soon. I will also learn how to say it. Thank you, May Grogan. Welcome aboard. So many new members. Very great to see that. People are laughing. People seem to be having fun. People now that don't like celery are chiming in, so we shouldn't have even started that. That's what I love about food, by the way. One of the great things about the food world is you can't ever prove someone right or wrong. If someone doesn't like, you know, yellow curry, you're never going to convince them it's awesome, and you don't need to. So that's what's nice about food. We get to eat and enjoy what we want and live and let live, let people enjoy what they want. Whatever your favorite food is, that's someone's least favorite food of all time, and vice versa. So there's no money in arguing this stuff. A Balco. What was I most thankful for on Thanksgiving? Just that Michelle and I were healthy, and we're able to spend the holiday together. And that we get to live in this gorgeous place and do what we love to do for a living and get to work for home. And, you know, are blessed that we get to make a living while so many people are now unemployed and struggling, which is so sad. But that they get to watch us and maybe get a few laughs while they're waiting for things to get back to normal. That makes us feel good. So I'm thankful for that. How do I feel about meat alternatives? I don't know. I think I like some of them. I've had fake chicken that I thought was delicious. It was made with the high gluten wheat. I'm going to try that soon. I think I'm very, sort of interested and, I don't know. I want to see how close I can get it. I hear people at the end of videos, oh my gosh, tastes just like chicken, which I find hard to believe. But I've had the Beyond Burger, or what's the other one? There's Beyond Burger, and then there's the Impossible Burger.
Yeah.
Impossible Burger is the one I prefer. I was blown away by how delicious it was. So yeah, I'm for, and I don't even like to call them meat alternatives. I like to just eat delicious things. So if you're calling it a meat alternative and it's a soy or gluten-based chicken alternative and you made a delicious stir fry with it and you give it to me, I really don't care what it's trying to replace. I'm just going to eat it and enjoy it. So I think that's the way to think about this stuff. Let's stop worrying about replacing things and let's just worry about adding things into our diet that are maybe better for us, better for the planet, although, you know, that some of that stuff's debatable, whether we're killing the planet by eating cheeseburgers. I don't know. Maybe we can eat a few. Is there somewhere in the middle we can land? Thank you, Falcon. Normally I try to thank all the new members, but it's going to be impossible today. This timeline or this chat is just flying by. And I'm going to be signing off pretty soon. I'm losing my voice, which happens after you talk for about an hour at my age. Dane Hennis, a member, wants to know, what's the carbon footprint on an Impossible burger? Well, there you go. So you don't really understand. The Impossible burger is not made from an animal. So there's no footprint. They don't have feet. There's no legs. So I don't think they leave any footprints in carbon. But I'm really not 100% positive on that. Mad World, thank you. Best nonstick pan, the last two chipped. I can't tell you. Is it Zwilling? I have a Zwilling nonstick pan I love. So there you go. I'll throw one brand out since they sent me a couple and I love them. In the spirit of full disclosure, they're sending me the pan may have, you know, altered my opinion, but not really. Great pans. Laura, thank you for laughing. Steak Dan's laughing. I'm not sure what about, but as long as you're laughing, it's all good. Don Bino, thank you very much. Favorite Persian food? I love, and I forget the name of it. You're going to have to help me. The duck that's braised with the walnuts and the pomegranate. Oh, my God. Oh, man. That is crazy good food. All right. Whatever the Persian recipe that's the duck roasted or braised with the, it's like a braisin liquid made with pomegranate and there's ground walnuts. Butchering the name. I think I got a couple of letters close. But anyway, that is my favorite Persian food probably. I absolutely love that. And by the way, when you ask a question that I don't know, which is like all the questions, people in the chat, they actually answer them and they give you brands and give you tips. And really, that's, I think, the whole purpose of this. Falcon wants to know, can we make the Russian burnt honey cake into a pie with the texture of buttermilk? I'm going to say no, because I don't know how you go about turning a cake into a pie. Can you make the buttermilk pie with burnt honey? I think you can. So if that's what you're asking, I would try that and report back. Captain Spaulding, thank you so much. Laura, thank you. Michael, thank you. Everybody, thank you. I'm going to sign off now. Oh, my God. Someone's telling me Fezijan is a pheasant recipe. Now I'm really embarrassed after dissing pheasant like that. I made it with duck, so I hope you're kidding. I can't help but think you're kidding. Grace, thank you so much. Mom of 14-year-old twins, want to learn cooking 2 years ago. I've tweeted you since. Thank you so much. I love you people teaching your kids how to cook or forcing them to learn how to cook. They will live much happier, much fuller lives because they have that knowledge. That is not even debatable. All right, just looking for the last couple member questions here. Laura, have I ever heard of Georgie Porgy Pie? No, but it's my new favorite recipe name. So I'm going to Google Georgie Porgy Pie. Is there pork in it? Sounds like there might be pork in it. Or you just made that up and you're messing with me, which I wouldn't blame you. Bill, okay, we'll leave. Chef, you and Michelle have a great week. You too, Bill. I'm not leaving until you do. All right, thanks to all the regular members who are here at every chat. You know who you are. Thank you so much. Thank you to all the new members. There was many of you today. Thank you for everyone who paid to ask a question, even though I probably missed it and you totally got ripped off. But, you know, I did my best. You have a couple seconds here if you want to just write it back in. And I'm going to stay safe. Thank you. And I'm going to stay distance. Thank you. And I will wear a mask. Thank you very much. So hopefully you all do the same. Have a great rest of your holiday weekend. Man, that went fast. Tomorrow's Monday. I can't believe it. Back to work. I'm going to be doing a very, very delicious, completely non-holiday recipe post on Tuesday for something called Korean street toast. And if you know what that is, you are very excited now because it's one of the most delicious things ever. It's basically a vegetable omelet sandwich with ham and cheese. And you're not going to believe it. It's crazy. It's so delicious. So we're going to throw that in on Tuesday. Since everybody wants a non-holiday recipe to break the monotony of the rich holiday foods. But then we're going to go right into the holiday recipes. I'm thinking about doing like a gingerbread biscotti. That sounds good. What about an eggnog? Either an eggnog semifreddo or an eggnog ice cream or maybe an eggnog panna cotta. Something eggnoggy and delicious that's not eggnog. And then maybe some kind of fancy holiday roast, although we've done them all. So I'm not sure which way to go in that direction. But anyway, as usual, I will be always monitoring the Twitter and the comments under the videos for your suggestions. Again, thank you so much. People seem to like those ideas I just threw out there. And I'm going to stop while I'm ahead. Grape Tomato Girl says, not hanging up till I hang up. No, you hang up. All right, everybody. Have a great rest of the weekend. Thank you so much. The support is so appreciated. And on behalf of Michelle and I, stay safe, have fun, and we'll see you next time. Oh, yeah. And as always, enjoy. All right. I'm going to hit the button. Here we go. Takes a minute. So there's always an awkward pause at the end. Here we go. End stream. But that doesn't end it. See, another button comes up. It says end up here. I got to go up here. Here we go. Bye.